with its fringes, surrounds our body by its four sides and shields us from evil temptations. Secondly, with the tefillin, due to their positions in our body, on the left arm opposite the heart and on the forehead opposite the brain, the two main organ factors in our existence, deviates us from falling into all temptations of sin and leads us towards the straight paths of religion and truth. Blessed be our God, who has created us for his glory and has given us the law of truth. May he open my heart into his law and his precepts, and may he place his love and fear within my heart, so as to do his will and serve him with a perfect heart, and make me a worthy and active member of the Jewish faith, to which I have the great honor and pride to be one of them. May he, with his ineffable mercies, bestow upon my dear parents, to whom I owe my greatest gratitude for all their cares and toil to bring me up as a religious and worthy citizen, his gracious blessings, and a long and prosperous life. Furthermore, may he also pour his blessings to my loving grandparents, dear brother, sister, uncles, aunts, relatives, teachers, and friends. And may he affirm unto myself the sayings of the holy prophets. Baruch HaGever Asher Yivtach B'Adonai V'Haya B'Adonai Yivtacho. Blessed is the man whose trust is in the Lord, and whose trust the Lord is. Amen.
Bishut HaRabbanim, Kahal Kadosh. My dear Ariel Shamuel, today you have attained your bar mitzvah. It is a day full of joy and celebration for you and for all of us. The Torah teaches us that you take today the responsibilities of manhood. To be an observant Jew is not easy, but I'm sure that you, dear Ariel, will be able to carry out your duties in a very honorable way. I know you very well through your parents, who are very good close friends of mine. And I'm sure you'll achieve a great deal in life because you are a hard-working, clever boy. Please do make use of your melodious voice, which gives us immense pleasure. Baruch Hashem, you have no problem in guidance. Your grandfather, a distinguished member of the community, president of the Hevra, who dedicates a lot of time for the service of others. Your father, who takes an active part in the running of this Beta Knesset, a great organizer, and has now started his Shabbat Shiur at home, which will benefit you a great deal. Today is Hanukkah Rosh Chodesh, a time of celebration and Nisim HaNiflaot, a time when the Hashmoneans fought against persecution, but won with their banner, Micha Mocha Ba'elim Hashem, putting faith in Hashem as their greatest weapon. Today we live here in Gibraltar in a freedom of religion society, and we thank the Almighty for having this privilege, and we take this opportunity of your bar mitzvah to ask him to protect us always and bless you and the whole community. Amen. I take this opportunity to present you this sefer on behalf of this Kahal Kadosh, wishing you the Siman Tov, the Kol Tov, and all the very best in life.
Yes, I'm going to be a Baruch HaMakosh
Hayye, جلس من الدولة حيث أكتوش الهند من الدولة حيث من أخوة مريرة شوال مريضاش في من الدولة حيث مفتام حيث قرآن كهارة كبير شديد من حيث قدوم كما لدوم مال كان يعلم هو دولة في الليل من أخوة مريضة شوال أخاري بحا يستحب الخلمة سولين يحول بحيث قبل خطب لامي لمس من دوم الدولة حيث هي لسول لنو مار أمين أدونا يلعيد وشمال مريضة شعين كايد يا عمود هشم هطوم البحور بنحمان
بنايا مغرب بنايا مغرب بروح التناي شب خربا نقوم من التلن وتسترط بروح التناي قال إلي أصف من دول قربانو كرب كسف أخات شوشين ومئة مشكلة مزرق خار كسف شبيم الشكل بشكل قدش شنين ملايين صولت برولا بشمل لميخة كف أخات أسرى زعب ملياك طورت فريخات بين بكار أيل خار كبس أخات مشنا طولو لا سير غزيم إخال خاتك وزبخة شلامي بكر شنايم هنين خمشة عدودين وخمشة كبسين من الشنة خمشة زي قربان إلي صاف بن نوال مت صرت نكد الشابر وخطرنا كما خلا مشنا طلن وتصرتو برات من الخيال نغابت وخلو وخطرنا نترى
آمين يتدال يتقداش مش مهربا يا ما نبرام تده يا حديث ما تده يا ما تده يا ما تده يا ما تده ولين دليل برا شبر ماولي منحات هانديل كريم باروخو لدناي بسيمانتو بسيمانتو مش مهربا ودرسدوش مسيوري مبرحب ياقوب شبه هرم يتدل شما ودرس رتو ربا خور نحما دليل شبه بديل مرحوش
יד אליך ומסביר לכוחה יסון וחטא אדוני אלינו כולם ומצילך מן הארץ.
Yeah. rabbis, parnasim, velilo and attendee families, ladies, gentlemen, and Aharon Chaviv, our dear Ariel. It is indeed a great pleasure for me to address you tonight, both as acting president in Haim's absence and as a great friend of our host for very many years. On these occasions, it is customary to give advice to the bar mitzvah boy. The best advice which I can give you, Ariel, is to emulate the qualities and midot of members of your own family. Let me go through some of these for your benefit. Starting with your Belilo grandparents, you have here two respectable members of our community who in their own quiet and unassuming way have contributed years of hard work and dedication to many thankless tasks in our community. I now turn to your grandparents on your mother's side. Many years ago, I, together with some of my friends, had the privilege of meeting the late Mr. Samuel Etetli, alav shalom. I say the privilege because we were invited several times by Mr. and Mrs. Etetli to their home in Casablanca, and we were all extremely impressed by the warmth and hospitality accorded to us. You see, Ariel, hospitality is not only to invite somebody home, but to make that person feel at home. Moving now to your uncle on your father's side, Mo and Doreen, from them you should learn, uncle and auntie, from them you should learn the importance of dealing with the senior citizens of our community, with the love care and attention which our senior citizens deserve. Apart from being totally devoted to his family, your dear father has dedicated many years of work to our community, both as Parnas of Shara Shamayim and as a member of the managing board, its executive, and also its registrar. Your father has always been available in an honorary capacity to both the community and the synagogue to advise on any engineering or other problem for which his valued advice has been frequently sought. And now finally, your dear mother. I do hope that both you and the future Mrs. Ariel Belilo, I don't know whether she has been invited by you tonight or not, are able to learn from the total dedication of your mother to her family, the excellent upbringing which your mother has always endeavored to give you, and all the many hours which she has spent in supplementing the school education at home should always be treasured by you. In conclusion, Ariel, as you map out your life, you should always remember these qualities which are so synonymous with your family. And Hashem will help you achieve goals which will make your parents, family, and community proud of you. I would finally like to sincerely thank, on behalf of all of us here tonight, both Mesod and Joel, for a beautiful simcha, and may we all be able to join them in the bar mitzvah of Gabriel and the wedding of Jessica.
Thank you. One, two, three. We will now ask... Please silence. Rabbi Hasid is going to address a few words.
Tonight to address a few words to the Bar Mitzvah, and it's especially a great pleasure, it's a very nice ambiance here, it's a nice place, maybe to be chosen by future B'nai Mitzvah for their own celebrations, but it's especially nice, the company which we find ourselves in, and tonight I had the privilege to sit on the right hand, of Rabbi Chaim. Unfortunately, in the last year, we've had to say so often, Nosea Falta, Rabbi Chaim, and Ruch Hashem today is with us. May Hashem send him a complete refuah shleima so that he should never be disappointed. I'll say I fell to my wife. Tonight has been and I do really feel most privileged to have been put next to her. You should know this is one of the rare occasions I have to speak to my wife. I think Hanukkah is an auspicious time. I'm not sure, but I think it's auspicious. I'm not sure what the word auspicious means, that's why. But I think it's auspicious to have a Bar Mitzvah. It's not only because the word Hanukkah is to do with chinuch. Chinuch is education. And Hanukkah is to do with education. Hanukkah means starting something off. Hanukkah and Mizbeach is when they first use the altar. And chinuch habayit, which you have sometimes, the first time you start using your house, and in your house you make a little party and you call it chinuch habayit. Same thing with chinuch, meaning education. When you start off a child's life, you start off with education, with chinuch. This is the first day that Ariel has put on his tefillin. And we know this is different from Bar Mitzvah celebrations in other parts of the world, where the young boy celebrates the last time in his life he puts on tefillin. since we've started on that, in for penny, in for pound. You know, they tell the story of the rabbi who went to a Bar Mitzvah celebration, and the hosts thought it wouldn't be fitting to give the guests ordinary iron cutlery, ironware. So they laid the tables with gold, real gold, solid gold cutlery. At the end of the meal, where the rabbi was sitting, the father's gold spoon was missing. So it's very embarrassing. You can't approach a rabbi and say, by the way, where that gold spoon came. So they said nothing, but the father of the Hatan, simply, he didn't speak to the rabbi for a long time. And after a few months, the rabbi approached him and said, is anything the matter? Did I say anything against you? Did I do anything wrong? Why did you speak to me? I said, look, I wasn't going to say anything, but now you brought up the subject. It's about that gold spoon, you know. When I came to the country afterwards, and your gold spoon was missing. I said, really? Is that very interesting? I thought your son would want to carry on using a gold spoon, so I put it in his tefillin bag. So he'd find it the next morning. To the auspiciousness of Hanukkah, the more serious note. We know that Chachamim introduced two new Yamim Tovim, new festival in Jewish calendar, apart from the ones in the Torah. One of them is Purim, and the other one is Hanukkah. And if you remember, Ariel, now I'm addressing my words to the Bar Mitzvah, we learned a few Sunday schools a day ago. Now, there is a difference in the way we celebrate Hanukkah and Purim. On Purim, it's a mitzvah to make a Seudah Purim. On the Hanukkah, we don't have this mitzvah. And the reason is, we learned, because on Purim, the life of the Jewish people was threatened. So how do we celebrate it? The body, whose existence was threatened, enjoys itself, was a physical threat, and we celebrate it in a physical way. On the Hanukkah, there was no physical threat. The threat was to the spirit of the Jewish people. The Greeks were trying to take away from us our religion. So the celebration is a spiritual celebration. We don't have a mitzvah of making a meal, making a seudah of Hanukkah. But there's something additional, something we didn't learn, something I want to tell you about tonight. And it's very interesting, the difference in the reaction of the Jewish people at Purim and Hanukkah. I could take this because I'm not. Tell them I'm busy. You just can't get away from the telephone, can you? There's a difference in the way the people reacted. On Purim, what happened? Haman threatened to destroy the Jewish people, and the reaction was not one of protecting themselves. They put on their sackcloth, and they said prayers, and they said Tehillim, and they prayed to Hashem to help them. On Hanukkah, the reaction was quite different. When the Greeks passed their evil decrees, they weren't allowed to wear Tehillim, they weren't allowed to keep Shabbat, Rosh Chodesh. The reaction of the Jewish people was to rise up against them and to protect their religion. And there's a very fundamental, very important idea behind this. Because when the Jewish life is threatened, he has to protect himself. Of course we have a mitzvah, we have an obligation to protect ourselves. But at the same time we have another mitzvah, a mitzvah of bitachon, which means faith in God. And that mitzvah tells us that our welfare, whether it's our parnasa, our livelihood, or our lives themselves, these things are in God's hand. And He wants us to do our little bit to protect ourselves, but ultimately we have to know that we're in God's hands, and it's His protection that we're asking for, and we're simply helping Him to help us to save ourselves. That's what happened on Purim. The people realized that. They didn't try to protect themselves physically. They prayed to Hashem, and He sent them to salvation. On Hanukkah, quite the opposite. There the Jewish life wasn't threatened. There the spirit of the Jewish people was threatened, and the religion was going to be taken away from us. And when that happens, it's no good for a person to say, I have bitachon, I have faith in God. God will save me, I'll pray to God to save me. That doesn't work. When your religion is threatened, then you have to take it into your own hands. We have bitachon, we have faith, that God will give us a livelihood, And your father is a person who understands this very well. Though we work, we know that ultimately each person's parent and Asai is a creed for him on Rosh Hashanah. And yet our lives are geared only to one thing. We spend our time working for O-levels, A-levels, and BAs, and MAs, and PhDs. Our whole lives geared towards earning a livelihood. And ultimately that is a thing which is not in our hands. And yet something which really is, something where we're supposed to do our own Mesirat Nefesh, to make ourselves sacrifices, to really fight for, which our spirituality, that is an area of our lives which we sadly neglect, unfortunately. So, whether Hanukkah is auspicious or not, depending on what it means, auspicious as it is, no, Hanukkah means, our blessing to the Bar Mitzvah. We know that he'll find the spoon in his tefillin bag tomorrow morning, but we expect of him much more than that. He has been blessed with a background, he's been brought up in a family who do take the mitzvah seriously, they take his Jewish studies seriously, they will encourage him to come to tefillah. And now it is up to you. Very soon you will indeed be 13 years old, and you will be responsible, entirely responsible for your own actions. Even though your father's mitzvah of education continues until much later, but now you'll be on your own, he is no longer punished for your sins. You have to stand on your own feet. And we give you our blessing as you'll carry on in your studies. You should place the same importance, at least the same importance, and make the same effort in your Jewish learning as you will in doing very well, I'm sure, in your O-levels and A-levels when they come. May God bless you and all our Gehillah.
Encontró una fuente que dio esa agua. manantial. Después se aprovechó de la sombra. Y antes de despedirse del árbol, dijo, árbol, qué verajá te podrá, qué bendición te podrá. Que tenga frutos dulces, buenos, yo lo he probado y mejores, no lo hay. Que tenga una buena sombra, la he visto yo. Que tenga agua para que pueda producir, también lo tiene. ¿Qué verajá te puedo? Al final dice, lo único que te puedo decir es que sea tus frutos como tú. Dulce como los tuyos, el agua, este agua que nunca se pare, nunca parte. Y esta sombra también para que todos nos aprovechemos. Y esa es la verajá que te puedo dar. Ariel Bar Mitzvá es el árbol, es allí mismo Mahatikimba, un árbol de Torah. Si es Neim Zemirot, lo tiene por parte de él y por parte de los padres. Si es Parnas, fue Parnas desde que estuvo en mi clase, cuando yo estuve en Sehul, de darle lección, que era el Parnas de la clase, se encargaba de todas las cosas. Así que yo le nombré Parnas en mi clase. Si es, como dijo Mr. Knight, mi dos robot, es uno de los pocos niños que hay. Hay Baruch Hashem, hay muchos, pero uno que se distingue de buenas cualidades, respeto a los maestros, los aprendiz a Jamil. Así que, ¿qué verajá te puedo dar para el Shabbat? Te puedo decir la misma verajá que dio ese Alá, de que tus frutos sean como los de tus padres, y que eso mismo lo herede para tu futura generación, que si ya está en Yod Gima, del Shilosh Estela Mitzvot, a decir de 15, de 13 a 18, que ya la jubá, hasta que vaya a Londres, que compre la ropa, y hasta que te prepares, los 5 años pasan como ya eres padre, como la sombra de un pájaro, dice la familia. Así que te vean tus padres y toda tu familia, que el próximo paso es la jubá. A Jamil, antes nada, perdone, excuse me, Rafa, for your nice words that you said in my thank you very much. Si he perdido una cosa de la nueva casa que he tenido, ha sido el cuarto vecino. Que me animaba a subir a la escalera, que siempre quería una canción. Enseguida me abría la ventana y eso me hacía subir. El ascensor, esa era mi ascensor. Subimos con música, no ser hayes. El Bar Mitzvá, a Jamil lo compararon con un un pez. El pez kasher tiene espina dorsal. El pez no kasher no tiene esa espina dorsal. Por lo tanto, cuando el pez tiene la espina esa dorsal, entonces no necesita ir a la corriente del agua, sino puede luchar contra la corriente del agua. Pero si no tiene esa espina dorsal, tiene que ir donde le lleva el agua, según la corriente. Y si Había un señor de aquí que está rico, padre de la gran mamá. Uno en Inglaterra, y en Inglaterra, por no molestarse, a las 2:30 dejaron mi hija. Inmediatamente, señora Arbi, dijo ese señor, Ripia, Hakam, Mariba Arbi, ¿dónde está la noche ahora, Arbi? Dice, aquí somos como los padres, ahí dijo la corriente, según la corriente, que te dice que es de noche, hay que hacer de noche. Arbi, Arbi, que es Saharita, hay que decir Saharita. Y eso, lo que el niño, Bar Mitzvah, el pez, kasher, el judío, en lo que no tiene que hacer, que tiene que ir según la corriente de la Torah. Si ve una contracorriente contra eso, que va al mal camino, tiene que luchar, tiene que ir tú contra esa, y no guiarte según lo que otro hace. Y esa es la diferencia de un pez kasher a un pez que no es kasher. Ahora, para probar si es verdad lo que yo dije, con eso terminaré, si ya he dado la bendición, padres, abuelos, todos, familias, hijos, alegres, tranquilos, y que le damos todo, fiesta y alegría, y siempre acuérdate lo que tus padres hicieron, familiares hicieron por esta seguridad. Seguridad, esto se llama seguridad de los humanos, pero para probar tu inteligencia, para saber si es verdad lo que yo he dicho, te quiero hacer una prueba. Y si te puede llegar aquí un segundo, con eso terminaré. Da, hemos dicho que da y fe, ¿no? ¿Qué suma la palabra da? Un día. Dale, ¿cuánto es? Gima, 3 por 7, en total me 7, by 3, 21. ¿Y tu nombre? Sama. 21, no, y tu nombre nada más, add 1. 22, entonces 22.
Consul, relatives and friends. As I was saying in my recent television appearance, before you can start building a tunnel, a considerable amount of groundwork preparation must first be carried out. This basic fact applies to life in general, and it is most applicable to the event that we are celebrating here tonight. Ariel, today you have celebrated your bar mitzvah, which has meant that you have today put on tefillin for the first time in your life. And now you become one more responsible member of Kehal Israel. But imagine what a disaster it would be if one started constructing a tunnel without having first studied the terrain and investigated the likely problems to be encountered and designed the tunnel construction accordingly. Similarly, you have had to undergo a considerable amount of training to prepare you for assuming your religious and social responsibilities so that you can successfully face your adult life. Your mother and I have over the years tried to impress upon you the importance of being responsible of helping others that are less fortunate than you, of being respectful to your elders, and of understanding the meaning of living within a united family. A fact which is one of the great pillars of a Jewish society. And at the same time, you are very fortunate in that living in Gibraltar has given you the opportunity of a religious instruction, an intense religious instruction from very dedicated teachers, and I think to them we are very most grateful. You have therefore been through the preliminary work required so that the tunnel that you dig for yourself in life is pointing in the right direction. It is now up to you to ensure that your sights are not deflected and that you strive to complete the tunnel successfully. Last summer, when we were deliberating the date of Ariel's Bar Mitzvah by a process of elimination, we decided upon this date, which happened to coincide with Rosh Chodesh and Hanukkah. What better date to combine this personal mitzvah of Tefillin with these two occasions? Firstly, Rosh Chodesh, which exemplifies the divine commandment by which the Jewish calendar was to be determined and executed by man. And secondly, Hanukkah, which represents the victory of monotheism over Hellenistic paganism. The Greeks attempted to outlaw the observance of Torah in general, and Rosh Chodesh in particular. What a vindication of the Hasmonean victory, the experience of today's triple celebration of Hanukkah, Rosh Chodesh, and Yom Bar Mitzvah. I was going to say that today was in fact a double Tefillin celebration. Double because today, in common with Ariel, I have had the privilege of also putting on a new set of Tefillin which I had ordered for myself some months ago and providentially arrived only a few days ago. I was going to say a double Tefillin celebration, but I have also found out that it is a triple Tefillin celebration today. Today also happens to be the 50th anniversary of the Bar Mitzvah of Mr. Isaac Israel. No marks given to guess Mr. Israel's age. Being a traditionalist at heart, I also made a point this morning's ceremony to wear the same tallet that I wore at my Bar Mitzvah 5 years ago, no, 28 years ago. And also the Darush that Ariel pronounced this morning was adapted by Rabbi Yaakov from the same Darush that I pronounced at my Bar Mitzvah and which was composed by the late Rabbi Moshe Ben Zimra, Alav Shalom. And again, following the line of tradition, we have here a bottle of wine at our table, which was dedicated by the Mohel at the ceremony of Ariel's Berit Milah. How is that for tradition? It is also a very well-known tradition in Gibraltar that whenever anybody, any family has a semacha, the whole community rushes in to assist with the organization. And ours has been no exception. Joel and I wish to thank all those persons who have in some way or other helped with all the arrangements. And coming closer to home, we wish to record our thanks to our relatives and our friends who have given so much time and effort to make it possible. To my dear mother-in-law, who has come over and helped us to keep our sanity during the moments when we thought it could not be done. To Aunt Henriette, who came over and took possession of our kitchen with such relish. Yay! To Dad and Mom, to say that Mom and Dad have helped us would be the understatement of the year. mean, who in our community has had a reception and have not been helped by that imam? There are so many more relatives and friends who have given us so much assistance that we would not like to offend anyone by omitting a mention. A very big thank you to all of you. Last but not least, a most important person without whom none of today's events would have been possible. And I refer, of course, to Joël. What is a man without a woman behind him? And what would I have achieved without having Joel's reserves of common sense to complement my engineering training? I would like to pay tribute to Joel for her good heart, her upbringing of family unity, her ability to befriend everyone around her, and her love. If I might just say that 2 weeks ago, I was asked if we could provide a little something for a celebration at Mount Alvernia, that Joel managed not only not to forget with the thousand of other things that she had in her mind, she managed to get round last Thursday and Friday to bake a cake and get me to rush it up to Mount Alvernia a few minutes before Shabbat. Finally, I wish to spare a thought for our relatives who for some reason or other have been unable to come. My brother-in-law, Armand, who no sé su falta, unfortunately has been prevented from being here. Meme, who is Ariel's great-grandmother, whom, please God, we shall be going to visit this week, was unable for health reasons to also make it here. And to all those relatives who have traveled such distances to celebrate with us, I think I wish to address a few words in French. And excuse my French, and I mean my French. Joël et moi, nous sommes très heureux de vous ayez pu venir nous joindre pour célébrer la bar mitzvah d'Ariel. Ma belle-mère, mamie, qui doit se partager entre les petits-enfants de Paris et celle de Gibraltar, tante Henriette, qui nous aime autant que ses propres enfants, Marianne et les enfants qui sont devenus des Gibraltariens honorifiques, Bob qui est si fier de ses neveux, Bébé qui maintient nos liens avec Casablanca, Gabi, Sarita, Stella, Daniel et Alain, Emma qui est venue au dernier moment. Nous sommes très honorés de votre présence ici ce soir. Merci beaucoup d'être venu et nous prions à Dieu que nous puissions nous réunir souvent dans des occasions heureuses comme aujourd'hui. Thank you all very much for coming. And may we always get together to enjoy Semachot in our community.
Waiting in the sidelines, for exactly 13 years, and I frankly feel that my time has now come to take over. Vice President, naturally, Fleur Hassan. She would act as my political advisor, and as Vice President, she would also be in charge of imposing a communal tax on all vices in the community, such as my grandmother's bingo sessions, etc. Honorary Treasurer, Benji Kubi of Walnut fame would occupy this post. Our financial policy would be very simple. The community would be divided into a House of Commons and a House of Lords. The House of Commons, which would hold the real power, would be run by us. The House of Lords would be another name for the House of Abu. Members of this house would do all irrelevant things, such as attending cocktails, standing in front, etc. However, to belong to this House of Abu, you would have to contribute handsomely to our coffers. Honorary Secretary, the natural choice would be Ruth Benedy, so that she could tell her mother exactly what to do. Something she has wanted to do for a long time. Committee members. Ilana Matana would be Minister for Organizing Dances. And Moshi Bensekri would be Minister in charge of making sure that all dancers would be strictly kosher. Similarly, Abigail Benaim would be in charge of organizing youth camps, while Yoshuita Salanes would be in charge of making sure that all camp activities were above board in all senses of the word. In conclusion, you would be very wise to vote for our party, as we would keep ourselves fully occupied and leave you the peace of mind which you are always saying we don't give you. Well, how about it? Now, on a more serious note, I do realize the very big responsibilities which I assume as from today, and I pray to Hashem that He will guide me throughout my life and help me make my parents, family, and community proud of my achievements. I would like to finish off by sincerely thanking my dear parents for having gone out of their way to make today such a memorable occasion in my life. My grandparents for their invaluable help, and all my relatives on my mother's side who have come especially for the occasion and whose presence here tonight has really made my bar mitzvah such a happy occasion. Thank you all very much.